Hello, Mary C. Williams friends. Today we're going to be doing what we've already been doing, which is comparing fractions using benchmarks. And this is lesson 52 on page 104. So join me there now. I am going to go over number 10 and 11 with you. Your job is going to be to turn in your work for 12, 13, 14, and 15 to us. All right, let's see. Sure, we can see. All right, so the first one is 6/10 compared to 2/5. Now, what you're supposed to be doing is thinking about the benchmark fraction 1/2. So, I'm going to show you how to do that. I know a lot of you have been turning in your work using area models, and that's completely fine, but I just want to show you what to think about when you think about the benchmark fraction 1/2. So, you want to think, is 6/10 greater than or less than 1/2? Well, if I have tenths as my denominator, what is half of 10? Yes, 5. So 5/10 equals 1/2. Is 6/10 more than 5/10? Yes, so this is greater than 1/2. 6/10 is greater than 1/2. Now we have to, it's a little tricky because this is a 5. So you have to ask yourself, what is 2/5 at least halfway? So if I had a number line and I cut it into fifths, here's 2/5. Does 2/5 look like it makes it halfway? Over here we have 1, 2 spaces, and over on the other side we have 1, 2, 3 spaces. So is 2/5 halfway? No, so this is less than 1/2. Because this is less than 1/2 and this is greater than 1/2, we automatically know 6/10 is greater than 2/5. If you really like to draw area models, you can draw your area models and you would still be able to see that 6/10 is greater than 2/5. All right, let's move on to number 11. We have 1/8 and we have 2/10. Now, let's start by thinking about the benchmark fraction 1/2. Your first denominator is 8. So you ask yourself, what is half of 8? Well, half of 8 is 4. So is this greater than or less than 1/2? Perfect. It is less than. And what about 2/10? What's half of 10? Perfect. 5/10. Is 2/10 less than or more than 1/2? Right, they're both less than 1/2, so this is a little bit tricky. So in a case like this, I would go ahead and say, let's draw those area models so that we can be 100% certain. And remember, make sure they are the same length. And do your best to make your pieces the same size. We have 8s, and we're going to find the halfway mark first. Wherever the halfway mark is at in that one, we're going to put it there. So 8s, I need 4 and 4. Even number, cut it in half to the best of your ability. Okay, we've got 8s. Now I need 10s. Now this one's a little bit trickier because it's 5 and 5. So I need a little less space for 2. And then 3, and then 2, and then 3. Let's see. We have 1/8, and we have 2/10. Which one is greater? Not by much, but I would definitely say 2/10 is greater. All right, my friends. You can use benchmark fractions to help you, but in a case like this, I would always use my area models or my linear models if you want to make number lines. Thanks so much.